Good morning, students. The topic of today's lecture is micro, small, and medium enterprises, commonly known as MSMEs. So we will start studying this topic. Coming to the introductory part, the Government of India has enacted the Micro, Small, and Medium Enterprises Development Act 2006. On June 16, 2006, which was notified on 2nd October 2006. With the enactment of MSMED Act 2006, the paradigm shift has taken place in the inclusion of services sector in the definition of micro, small, and medium enterprises, apart from extending the scope to medium enterprises. So, students, the Act MSMED was enacted in 2006, and in this act there is a paradigm shift, very important thing, with the inclusion of service sector in the definition of MSMEs. So as you all know that earlier manufacturing sector was the only one who was dominating the market, but with the passage of time in late 90s and early 20s, service sector is also establishing itself, and till now it has established itself in such a way that it is really, really important part of our economy. So keeping in this thing in mind, it has been included in the definition of MSMEs. Coming to the definition part, MSMED Act 2006 defines the micro, small, and medium enterprises based on the investment in plant and machinery for those engaged in manufacturing or production, processing or preservation of goods, and on the investment in equipment for enterprises engaged in providing or rendering of services. So the definition includes two things: investment in plant and machinery, that is related to manufacturing sector or production sector, and other thing is investment in equipment for enterprises engaged in producing or rendering of services. So it goes two ways now. As you can see the chart below, enterprises are being categorized into two things: manufacturing as well as service. Coming to the manufacturing part, in micro, the cap has been set up to 25 lakhs. In small, the cap of investment in plant and machinery has been set up to 5 crores. And in medium, under manufacturing, the investment in plant and machinery has been capped up to 10 crores. Coming to the service sector side, in micro, the cap has been set up to 10 lakhs. In small, the investment cap in equipments is set up to 2 crores, and in medium, the equipment investment has been set up to 5 crores. So this is the pictorial description of this definition. Moving further, now we will study some characteristics of MSME. First is labor intensive. So students, let's take an example of a company where a large number of workers are there, and the functioning of that company is more dependent upon the workers rather than technology or machines. So such kind of company is labor intensive, where more labor is involved in processes and more importance is given to the employees or labor. Second is less capital required. So as you have already seen the definition, read the definition of MSMEs, in developing economy like India, the importance of MSMEs cannot be doubted upon. So with less investment, less capital, entrepreneurship is promoted, and that too at a very lower level with the help of central and state governments. Third is short gestation period. So the time duration related to the growth, time duration related to the birth till growth of this MSMEs is short. Fourth is helps in decentralization. So when new entrepreneurs come up, when many companies either at small level or medium level come up in a single industry, then it is a kind of decentralization and removal of monopoly. Then next is greater flexibility. Whenever we talk about MSMEs, with small investment, they have the ability to explore new ways of doing the same things which are being conducted in the market. Then greater flexibility approach takes place. And this is very beneficial for overall development of economy. Next is large market share. When entrepreneurs are given opportunity through MSME Act to start their new ventures and they try to explore the market and government helps them, that leads to large market share and they are given the opportunity to capture the market. Next is employment generation. Students, the number of risk takers, that is entrepreneurs, is very less in our society. More and more people look for jobs to be employed by someone else. And when the number of MSMEs increase, the scope of employment in those MSMEs for common youth or the youth who wants to do the job gets more and more. And more employment is being generated with growth of MSMEs. So these were the characteristics of micro, small, medium enterprises. Now we will come up to role of MSME in Indian economy. MSMEs and their contribution to the growth of India. As you can see this picture, 45% of manufacturing output is done by MSMEs, then employs 110 million people, then 50 million MSMEs in India are there. 17% of GDP is being generated by MSMEs and 40% of the total export done by India is being done through MSMEs. So this is the importance. Actually, this is the main chunk of importance of MSMEs in India. Now we will come to the importance of MSMEs. First is facilitates women growth. Women empowerment is the most crucial topic nowadays. Women are equal to men, and I would say women are more than equal to men in every field of life. And MSMEs give opportunity to aspiring entrepreneurs to come forward, avail various benefits and subsidies, and come up with new ideas and launch their business venture. Even women who are really great in creativity and innovation do come up with their new business ideas and become entrepreneurs, I would say successful entrepreneurs, and this facilitates the growth in women. Second is brings balanced regional development. Students, there are some rural areas, there are some backward areas which are being given special subsidies by government, and government promotes to generate MSMEs in those areas. They try to develop MSMEs in those areas so that people of those areas can be given employment and they can become economically uplifted. So it brings balanced regional development. Third is helps in mobilization of local resources. Local resources are really important. When MSMEs are developed, there is mobilization of local resources. It can be through materials, man, or machinery or anything. And that helps in overall growth of economy. Then next is paves for optimization of capital. Then next is promotes exports. As you have seen earlier also, 40% of the export done by India is being produced through MSMEs. Then complements large scale industries. Large scale industries, yes, are very important for any economy. They are the backbone. They produce the major chunk. But MSMEs are the ones who support large scale industries, because large scale industries cannot survive alone. They need some other enterprises who produce various materials which are helpful for them. Next is meets consumer demands. Consumers are the backbone of market, and when consumers expect something, MSMEs produce those things at much cheaper costs with lesser number of resources involved, and this helps in two-way win-win situation. Next is ensures social advantage. Having entrepreneurs at social level, entrepreneurs at lower level, and with less number of investment, then it becomes a social benefit, because entrepreneurs are always beneficial for economy. Then next is develops entrepreneurship. This we have been discussing. This is the table which we can see performance of SSI, small scale industries, MSMEs, employment and investments. Students, you can see the years 2006 to 7, 7 to 8 and so on till 2014 to 15. Total working enterprises, the number of enterprises have increased. Employment in lakhs is given, that has also gradually increased. And market value of fixed assets, that has also increased by years. So students, this is the power of producing MSMEs. This is the advantage to which economy is getting through MSMEs, and employment is getting increased, and the number of MSMEs are increasing, employment is increasing, market value is increasing, and this all combined together leads to the overall growth of economy. Now this is the contribution of MSME sector in GDP and output. This is also given year wise, starting from 2006 to 7, then 7 to 8, 8 to 9 and so on till 2012 to 13. Gross value of output of MSME manufacturing sector has gradually increased, as you can see the data. Manufacturing sector, then service sector is given, then total is given, and share of MSME output in total manufacturing output percentage. This has also been showing the same data, which is very beneficial for the growth of Indian economy. Now there are various challenges for MSMEs which we need to study. They are very important. First is finance. Sometimes shortage of finance can be a reason behind challenges for MSMEs to grow. Then raw material shortage can be there. Right number of and right type of suppliers cannot be found sometimes. Then idle capacity. Then technology. Technology is like sometimes costly and sometimes it is not available so easily. Then marketing of products done by MSMEs is not up to the mark in comparison to large scale industries. Then sometimes MSMEs do not have the required infrastructure, and this is a great barrier for new entrepreneurs. Then underutilization of capacity. Sometimes there is lack of experience, there is lack of expertise in new entrepreneurs, and that leads to underutilization of capacity. Then project planning can be a problem if not done properly. Then skilled manpower is not available to new entrepreneurs, new ventures, and that leads to a decrease in productivity, and that can also be a challenge. Then managerial challenge can be also there, because sometimes new entrepreneurs do not have that experience of planning, controlling, directing, organizing. So these are few of the challenges which are there, but with spending some time upon these things and focusing upon these things, these challenges can be overcome. Now we will study advantages of MSMEs. First is close supervision, with less number of employees, with a small workplace environment, close supervision can be done. Then nature of demand can be met easily. More employment is generated through MSMEs. need of small capital. With small capital, a new venture can begin. Then direct relation with work between workers and the employers. Yes, the when new venture begins, the employers are also working there, workers are also working there, the units are at small scale level or medium scale level, so there are direct contact between them. Then direct relation between customers and producers. Yes, producers are there, they want to serve the customers and they are already all time available and customers are most welcome to approach them. So there is direct relation between customers and producers. And last is easy management. Because the ventures are not too big, so it is easy to manage them conveniently with a lesser number of resources involved. Now coming to the disadvantages, high cost of production. Students, we have studied the economies of scale topic. And in that thing, we have studied that whenever things are manufactured at a very large scale, the cost of production lowers itself. But in small scale industries like MSMEs, when the production is not done at very much large level, so high production cost is incurred by the company. Then next is less use of machines. It is more labor intensive, as we have studied earlier also, so less number of machines are used. Then lack of division of labor, difficulty in getting loans sometimes. They do not have sufficient assets to show the banks or the other institutions that yes, they can be beneficial for the economy, so it becomes difficult for getting loans. Then costly raw materials and lack of research is there. R&D development, R&D wing is not much developed, and competition is always a problem because large scale industries are available in the market. So students, in this lecture we have studied various aspects of MSMEs, starting with the introduction, then definition, then what role MSMEs play, their importance, then how MSME is beneficial for Indian economy, their advantages, their disadvantages, what are the various caps set by the government. I hope this lecture was very beneficial for you all. Still, if you have any doubt, you are most welcome to ask me. Thank you very much.